Good morning. Today I would like to take the time and speak about a very, very important topic, which is called self-confidence. Unfortunately, today a lot of people don't have that attribute of self-confidence in themselves, and even more so, worse off, they don't have confidence even in their children. What do I mean? Unfortunately, today we have what's called the technology, the media, iPhone, Androids. All these things are occupying our lives day in, day out. We spend more time with technology than we do with our own families. So what happens in return is very simple. When the child sees that the parents are on their iPhone more than when they're with their children, the children get one message only, that the phone is much more important than the child. So therefore now the child feels that he's not important. So therefore now the child won't have that confidence. And so too, whether it's going to be a spouse, husband or wife, when the husband is very much into the media, into the technology, into his iPhone, the computer, the TV, when a person is into these things, the wife only gets one message. And that message is that the phone, his TV, his sport are much more important than me. So therefore she starts to see that she has no importance in this world, and therefore they start losing hope for anything they want to accomplish. Today I would like to speak about a certain bracha that we say every single morning, and I would like to give the reason behind that blessing that we say in the morning, and I would like to read it in the Lashon HaKodesh, in our holy language, because only for you guys to see what it means to have self-confidence in oneself and what it means to have confidence in your spouse and in your children. Because if we're not going to give it to them, Rahman Sallallahu Alaihi is going to be bad. Now while the children are small, we are still able to go ahead and move them, shape them to whatever we want them to be. But if we're not going to do it now and the tree becomes older and older, it's going to be very hard to straighten out the tree. So this one, this bracha that we say every single day is the bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach. Let me read for you what the Shulchan Aruch has to say, and then let me tell you the reasoning behind it. The Shulchan Aruch says in Siman Memvav Halacha Vav, Yesh Nohagin Levarech Hanoten La'ev Koach. You have people that have the custom of saying the bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach. The bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach literally means that Hashem gives strength to the people that are weary or tired. However, the Mechaber says, Rabbi Yosef Karo says, I don't like their words, meaning to say that a person should not say the bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach. The reason being is because in the Beit Yosef he brings out in Siman Memvav Otvav, because this bracha is not mentioned in the Gemara, the Beit Chadash says that it is mentioned, there were different texts, does not matter guys, it's a very big machloket in itself. But the Rama says over here, Ach haminat pashur b'bnei Ashkenazim lomram, that the simple minhag amongst Ashkenazim is to say the bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach. So we do have a machloket over here between the Sephardic rabbi, Rabbi Yosef Karo, and the Rama, the Ashkenazi rabbi, the Ashkenazi posuk. So I'll put it to you like this, guys. It's a very big machloket, but the ma'aseh, what do we do to Sephardim? We actually also follow the Rama over here, that the minhag is to go ahead and say the bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach for different reasons, and we do not follow the Shulchan Aruch in this case. So this bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach, that Hashem gives strength to the weary, to the people that are tired, what does it mean? Why is it so important? So I'm looking into the Torah right now, in Siman Mevav Otvav, the Torah says like this, Unitkana al sha'adam makpid nishmato be'erev b'yad HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This bracha of Hanoten La'ev Koach was instituted because when a person goes to sleep at night, he deposits his soul, his neshama, to the hands of Hashem. Ayifa me'avodat kasher kol hayom, tired from a long day of work. U'machzira lo baboker shekatan u'shalvam, Hashem returns your neshama all rest, all well rested. Can you imagine, guys? the ness, the miracle that Kadosh Baruch Hu does for us every single day, day in, day out, day in, day out. You giving your neshama well, tired, meaning mamish, exhausted to no end. You wake up in the morning, you feel fresh. The two continues and he says, can you imagine? He says, Basar v'dam makpid pikadon biyad chaveru. Can you imagine that when your friend would deposit something by you, he would tell you that go ahead, use my thing that I'm giving you now. The friend is going to return the object all worn out and ruined. Aval adam makpid bechol erev nishmato biyad HaKadosh Baruch Hu v'yayifa umachzira lo chadasha urgu'am. However, when we give our neshama back to Kadosh Baruch Hu every single night when we go to sleep, all tired, Hashem gives it back to us, all fresh. Guys, I would like to give you guys a small parable. Can you imagine that if you went ahead, I'm just going to take any car for argument purposes. Can you imagine if your friend, he has a Bentley, a Mercedes-Benz and a BMW in his garage. So you guys are best friends. So you tell your friend, listen, can I use your Bentley today? I need to take out my wife somewhere special. I want her to feel special. So your friend says, of course, go ahead, take my Bentley. He gives you the car in the morning, and you return to him the car in the evening. But when you give the keys to your friend says, can I go see the car? Is everything okay? He says, go ahead, look at the car. What's the problem? The friend, he goes look at his car, and he sees that the car is crashed up. There's a dent over there. He put a flat tire, the window is broken, etc. I want to ask you guys a question. What are the chances that tomorrow morning, when the same friend that ruined this guy's car, when he comes back again and he tells him, give me your BMW now, I want to take out my wife again for dinner, what are the chances that this guy is going to give him his car again? The chances are zero. You know why? Because how can I trust you again if you went ahead and you ruined my first car, an expensive car? What does this have to do with us? The parable of the story goes like this, guys. The Torah is telling us something very important. That when you're giving an object like this car to your friend and he gives it back to you worn out and ruined, the friend the next day won't give you the car back. Any other car he won't give you back. However, guys, when it comes to Kadosh Baruch, when it comes to Hashem, we give our neshama back to Hashem, not only tired, we even ruin our neshama sometimes, Rahman al-Islam, with sins, with Averot, Rahman al-Islam. All worn out, tired, beat up, and we go to sleep like nothing. And we wake up in the morning and Hashem gives us a brand new neshama, a fresh neshama, to start the day again. Can you imagine? It's not one time. He does it for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. I ask you guys one question, why? Doesn't Hashem know that tomorrow the person is going to do sin? Doesn't he know that tomorrow the person is going to do a marriage with X, Y, and Z, with this girl, with that girl? He's going to look where he's not supposed to. He might not put on tefillin, he might not keep Shabbat. Doesn't Hashem know these things? So the truth behind this halakha is like this, guys. Hashem knows, guys, but you know what? Hashem says, I want to give you another chance. Every day that you have your neshama return back to you, that's only because Hashem wants to give you another shot that you should be able to do teshuva, that you should be able to repent and come back to your Father in heaven. Guys, this bracha is a little bit more than what we think. I want to explain to you in a mashal, in a way of a parable. Many years ago when I used to watch sports, Baruch Hashem, I don't watch sports. It was a very, very big battle to not watch sports. I was a very big fan of football and basketball. I myself, for one, played football. I was a very good quarterback. That's one of the reasons why I went to St. John's, because I wanted to play on the football team. In any event, all I'm trying to tell you, it takes a lot of strength and power and siyata d'shamayah, help from Hashem, to be able to stop watching sports or anything else, Rahman al-Islam, that's on the TV. So I remember many years ago when they used to have the finals in the NBA, in the basketball championships, that if there was 4 seconds left on the clock, the coach would call timeout and he would get the best player in the team and he would tell him, you are taking the shot. He would draw out a plan And then he would tell the guy that you're going to take the shot, you take it, you're going to win. So they inbound the ball, the plan goes as planned, the guy, the best player in the team, gets the ball, and he looks at the time clock, and the time is winding down, and he's hesitant to shoot the ball. He passes the ball off to another player, the player shoots, he misses the ball, they lose the finals. When they go into the locker room, the coach tells him, let me ask you a question. Why didn't you take the shot? You make the shot day in, day out. Every single day you make the shot. Why didn't you take the shot? So the player told the coach, I was afraid. I didn't have the confidence that I was going to be able to make that shot. That's the reason why I passed it off. Maybe he could make it. The coach told him like this. Let me tell you something. You didn't have confidence in yourself, but I have confidence in you that you would make it. If I have confidence in you that you would make it, at least the least you could have done was have confidence in me that I have confidence in you that you're going to make it and take the shot. Whether you make it or not, that's irrelevant. But the least you could have done was believe in me. I'm the coach. I know what I'm doing. Guys, the parable of the story is very simple. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, every single day, he gives the neshama back. And we wake up in the morning and we know that this world is a very dark world that we have to fight with all the temptation that there are, that there is outside, with all what's going on, Rahman al-Islam, on the internet. With the press of a button, you could be in another world, you could be watching things, Rahman al-Islam al-Aleinu. Things that was unheard of a few years ago, it's unbelievable. What does Hashem say? He says, I know it's hard for you. I know, I see it's hard for you. But do me a favor, Hashem says. Do me one favor. Trust in me, the fact that I returned your neshama. I believe in you, that you could do teshuvah. Trust in me. You don't trust in yourself because it's really hard. I agree with you guys. But why don't we just trust in Hashem? The least we can do is trust in Hashem, that He trusts in us, that we're going to be able to do teshuvah and come back to our Father in heaven. Now guys, I want to make this clear. It's not easy to break off from doing the bad things that we do. But one thing I'll tell you, any little, the most minute thought of repentance by HaKadosh Baruch Hu, by Hashem, is the biggest thing in the world. That's why in Siman Aleph Halacha Daled it says, Echad HaMarbeh V'Echad HaMamid Bilvad Shechven Kol HaShamayim. Hashem wants your heart. He doesn't care if you're going to do a lot, you're going to do a little bit. As long as what you're doing it for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So if you want to do teshuvah, and it's not easy for you to break off right immediately from everything bad, beseder. But start somewhere, work up, have a goal to work yourself up. I'll give you a very simple example, guys. In order for me to be able to break off from watching football and basketball, I had a system of how I did it. Instead of watching it every single day, I used to watch every single day. It was hours. I used to waste hours upon hours. I was just becoming religious, hours upon hours. I would watch basketball over and over, the same play. Eventually, I said to myself, look, I'm not going to watch during the day. I'm only going to watch during the night. So I would watch Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Not on Shabbat, of course. Sunday, etc. I would watch. And then I made a plan that I can't do during the day too many days because I'm not able to grow like that. I'm not able to serve Hashem. So then I decided that I have to make an end to this. So I decided a few days during the week. After a few months, I decided only Sundays. I only wanted to watch the sports Sundays because this way I was able to have control over the time during the week. But even when it came to Sundays, then I said to myself, if I was able to break my habit during the weekdays, what's in it for me now that why shouldn't I be able to break the Sundays itself? So that's how eventually, after many months of hard toil, exertion, I was able to break myself off from sports. Baruch Hashem, with Hashem's help. But the truth is, guys, when I did do that, many times I had the battle to go back and watch, and I did fall, but then I didn't get back up. And Baruch Hashem, now maybe 10 years now, maybe more, I am not watching sports because I feel that it's a mamish, a waste of time, and I have a better connection with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I enjoy learning Torah, I enjoy learning mitzvot, I enjoy learning Torah, I enjoy doing mitzvot, and I enjoy davening to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I feel a certain connection that once you take out all the vanities of this world, you are able to connect to something else, meaning to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to His Torah, to His mitzvot. Because if you're not using your energy there, you have to be able to use your energy somewhere else. So this energy, you want to be able to direct it to Hashem, guys. So therefore, guys, why we started with this whole thing of self-confidence. If you want to have self-confidence in yourself, I know it's difficult because of what's going on. But the least we could do is to have confidence in Hashem, that He has confidence in us. And with this, that Hashem has confidence in us, may that give us the strength to be able to continue in our ways in living in this world and not to chas v'shalom make and not to fall into any traps of the Yetzer Hara. Okay guys, this will be the shiur for today. Baruch Adonai Olam. Amen ve'amen.